Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see what is oEmbed protocol and how to embed the third-party content with oEmbed. oEmbed is an open format designed to allow embedding content from a website into another website. When you share media from an external source and place it on your own site, it's called embedding. And it's normally achieved with some piece of code. HTML iframes, inline frames were a common way to embed content, but they are usually a headache for developers. Luckily, oEmbed is the latest format for embedding and it's slowly replacing the static iframes. oEmbed is a specification for allowing an embedded representation of a URL on third-party sites through the use of exchanges. The oEmbed exchange occurs between a consumer and a provider. Many content providers implement oEmbed, such as YouTube, Vimeo, Flickr, Twitter, etc. The provider that implements the oEmbed API allows the consumers to fetch the resource representation by using a predefined set of endpoints, the URLs that accept queries for embedded resources. The consumer is a website that displays an embedded representation of a third-party resource, such as photo, news update, or an embedded video. When querying an oEmbed URL, the provider responds with either a JSON or an XML document. This can be chosen by adding a format parameter to the query URL. The response document contains the information about the embedded resource, such as its width and height, type of the embed, example video, audio, or etc. And most importantly, the HTML code to embed the resource into a website. If you see this diagram, the consumer sends the GET request to the provider's oEmbed API endpoint with the resource URL as the query parameter. Also, you can specify the format parameter, either JSON or XML. Also, some other parameters are there that we can see it further. Then the provider responds the resource details along with the HTML embed code in a JSON or XML format. The HTML embed code can be used to display the resource in the website. This approach can be used against all the providers support this oEmbed APIs. The standard list of providers can be accessed from here, oEmbed.com, providers.json. If you see here YouTube, it has provider name, providers URL, then endpoints, schemes, and URL. Also discovery equal to true. Let me search for Vimeo. Again, Vimeo, then provider URL, then the schemes, then URL. So even the URL format can be changed. Here the URL itself supports the format, but other cases you can send the parameter format with JSON or XML. The scheme describes which URLs provided by the service may have an embedded representation. If you see here, the YouTube video URLs matching with these patterns will have the embedded representation. Example, star.youtube.com/watch*, then or star.youtube.com/v/*, or youtube.be/*. The endpoint URL describes where the consumer may request the embedded representation for the resources. The request to the API endpoint is HTTP GET. This supports different arguments as a query parameters. All the query parameters should be URL encoded. These are the supported query parameters. The first one is URL. This is mandatory. URL to which the embedding information should be retrieved. Next one is max width. This is again optional. The maximum width of the embedded resource. Next one is max height. This is again optional. The maximum height of the embedded resource. The last one is format, optional. Response format, either JSON or XML. Refer to this for response parameters. Some are type, version, title, author name, author URL, provider name, provider URL, then cache age, thumbnail URL, then thumbnail width, thumbnail height. Then also based on the type, the resource type, some parameters will change. For photo, URL, width and height. For video, again, we are having HTML, width and height. Same way, link, then rich. Again, it will have HTML, width and height. Let us quickly access the embed representation of some of the resources. The first one is youtube.com. The embed API is youtube.com, oEmbed. Then the URL parameters. Then again, I am sending the format, JSON, max height, then max width. The API endpoint can be fetched from here, the providers.json. So YouTube URL is youtube.com/oEmbed. You can URL encode this parameters. So you can use this, the URL, YouTube URL, then encode that. So if you see here the response, title, author name, then author URL, type is video, height and width, then version. I requested for different height, but it's the supported, so 281. Then width is anyway 500, I requested for 500. Then version, provider name, provider URL, thumbnail height and width, then thumbnail URL, also the HTML. If I go to that, you can see the HTML here. The HTML is Unicode encoded, so you should be decoding before using it. Yeah, this is the decoded HTML. Same way, this is for Flickr. So flickr.com, services, oEmbed, then format, JSON, then URL, the resource URL. This returns the response. The HTML can be used to embed the resource into the website. Same way, Vimeo.com, API, oEmbed.json, then URL, the Vimeo video URL. Here if you see the difference is oEmbed.json, the URL itself supports the format. Either you can specify as a JSON or XML. Returns the response, it has again HTML that can be used to display the resource in website. This is the embed code written by YouTube API. So iframe, then the corresponding width, height, then SRC, then other parameters. So let me quickly open this HTML. If you see here, the video is displayed with the corresponding height and width. The providers are managed through this specific repository. So even you can request for adding new provider into this list. If I open youtube.yaml, so you can see the details, provider name, all those details earlier we have seen through this provider.json. Also the providers can enable the discovery through this link element, means rel alternate, then type equal to application slash JSON slash oEmbed, alternate again, text slash XML plus oEmbed. The same can be enabled through response headers, link, and you can follow this pattern. The oEmbed helps us to embed the resources from different providers through a standard API. Also, this helps us to embed the resources from known URLs. Another benefit is the resource is embedded to the website through the provider-supported embed option. Example, iFrame. You can use the embed API to receive the JSON or XML representation of the resources along with the HTML embed code that can be used to display the resource in the website. That's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video.